also selection in. Now we are going to discuss selection of AP and selection of GP in different scenario, right? And how do we select the AP, the number of terms, okay? So you can say that selection, the word is what? Selection. Exact word of selection of AP. फिर मैं इसमें डिस्कस करूंगा सेलेक्शन ऑफ एंड द सेम इधर इन द सेम सेकंड पोर्शन वी कैन डिस्कस सेलेक्शन ऑफ जीपी. फर्स्ट वी विल डिसाइड हाउ टू सेलेक्ट थ्री और मोर टर्म्स आर इन जीपी. क्लियर? इसको सेलेक्ट कैसे करेंगे, दैट इज द मेन क्राइटेरिया. सपोज दैट देयर आर द थ्री टर्म्स, हियर इज योर थ्री टर्म्स आर गिवन. Suppose three terms are given and the common difference is what? Let common difference, that is your D. Three terms common difference D, your term will be what? Your term will be A minus D. Your term will be, first term is A minus D, then A and, first is A minus D, then A and A plus D. It's selection of three terms in AP, common difference is D. This is your first term, this is your second term, and this is your third term, right? This is the first criteria, how to select three terms in AP. If they ask four terms, if the four terms are in AP, how can you select? Then if four terms you are selected in GP, AP, sorry, the common difference is what? That is 2D. Now common difference is 2D. Your first term is A minus 3D. Second term is A minus D, because common difference is 2D. First term is A minus 3D. Second term is A minus D. Third term is A plus D. And the fourth is A plus 3D. Clear? So this is first, second, third, and fourth term are in AP. If they ask five term are in AP, then again common difference is D. Then again, common difference is D. So you can select the number like A minus 2D. This is your first number. And the common difference is D. So second number is A minus D. And the third number is A. Fourth is A plus D. And the next one is A plus D. This is your first. This is your second. This is your third. This is your fourth. And this is your fifth number. Right? So these are the procedure. So you can select the numbers, or you can say selection of AP. Three terms, four terms, and fifth term. Right? The base question of this one, it's been based, we can do one or two solved example on selection of AP and GP. First, we are going to decide in AP. First, we are going to discuss AP. Right? They ask, if the sum of three consecutive terms of AP is 51, sum. They are given what? Sum is 51. Three numbers. So three number is what? A minus D, A, and A plus D. If their sum is what? So you can going for addition, like this one is equal to 51. Minus D plus D cancel out. So 3A is equal to what? 3A equal to 51. So A equal to 70. So the first answer number A is what? 17. And also given that, and the product of two extreme values is 273. And the product two extreme. What is the meaning of extreme is here? The meaning of extreme is here. This one number and this one number. These are the extreme numbers in the selection of three numbers, right? And they ask, product of these extreme number is 273. That means A minus D into A plus D equal to 273. A minus D into A plus D is equal to 273. Putting down the value of 17 in this one. First of all, you can use the relation A minus D into A plus D, that is A square minus D square. So you can write A square minus D square equal to 273. And what is A? A is 17. So 17 square is what? 289. So 289 minus D square equal to 273. Shifting towards this one, we can calculate 289 minus 273 square root. of course, square root 16. So that is what? D is equal to what? Plus minus 4, I think. So D is equal to plus minus 4. Because D here is what? Here is D square equal to 16. So D is equal to plus minus 4. So in this scenario, you can calculate three numbers, first number, second number, and third number. First of all, given condition is what? The sum of three number is 51. Let first number is A minus D, second number is A, and third number is A plus D. According to given condition, adding on this one, we will get 51. Calculate this one, we get A equal to 17. And the second condition is what? The product of extreme value, this and this number are known as the extreme value, extreme function value, or you can say extreme term. Right, so this one product of these two is given 273. So A minus D into A plus D is 273. Value put down here is 70. You can get A square minus B square, that is A plus B into A minus B. In this one scenario, you can calculate the value of B square equal to 16. So D equal to plus minus 4. Putting down the value of A and D in this one, this is your first number, this is your second number, and this is your third number. So in this way, you can calculate. If the four terms are in AP, or three terms are in AP, or five terms are in AP, selection of these criteria, you can solve this such type of question. Clear? So these are what? These are the selection of the numbers in AP. So that's similar way. In similar way, we can also go for in GP. Selection of the more than three, four, and five terms are in GP. You can construct on this one, right? So I am going to take some more example on if the numbers they are selecting in a GP. For example, three terms are in GP. Here is the terms. Three terms are in GP. Then common ratio is what? Then your common here GP is what? Common ratio, that is R. If the three terms, you can write three terms are in GP, common ratio is R. You can select a number as A upon R, A and AR. These are the three numbers. Your first number is A upon R, second number is A, third number is AR. If suppose four terms are in GP, then common ratio again, that is what? That is R square. Here is what common ratio. In AP, there was common difference, but here in GP, the exact word is common ratio. That is what? R square. So first term is what? A upon R cube. Second is what? A upon R. Then A. Then AR. Because here is R square, na? Then AR. Then next one is what? Third number is AR. And the fourth number is what? AR cube. AR cube. Why cube here? Because your common ratio is R square. If the fifth term you are selecting in GP, common ratio is R square. This is your first term, second term, third term, and fourth term. Similarly, in five terms are there. If there are five terms in GP, your common ratio is again R. Common ratio is again R. You can select as a number. That is what? A upon R square, comma. This is your first number. Second number is A upon R, comma. Third is what? A. Next one is what? AR. Then AR square. This is first number, second number, third, fourth, fifth number are in GP. You can take common ratio is R. If the four number are in GP, you can take this condition and you can take common ratio R square. And if the three numbers are in GP, you can take this one. So in this one scenario, you can get or you can calculate these value. A three term, four term, or five terms might be in a GP or AP. You can easily way. You can create a system to solve this such type of problem in very easy manner, right? For example, they asked find three numbers in GP whose sum is 28. Given is what? Sum is 28. They ask find three numbers. Find three numbers. So first find three number. Number is what? First number is A upon R plus A plus AR is equal to 28. This is your first equation. a upon r plus a plus ar is equal to 28. And they said, and their product is 512. And this is the product. Second condition, product a upon r into ar. Product is what? That is 512. This is 512. R and r is cancelled out. A into a, that is a cube. So a cube is what? 512. So a cube is 512. Right? So a is what? A is 8. Because 8 cube is this one. 8 cube is this one. So a equal to 8. Putting down the value of a in the first equation, you can easily get the value of r. So put down the value of this one. So 8 upon r plus 8 plus 8 into r equal to 28. From here, you construct the quadratic equation and calculate the value of r. You will get two value of r. Right? How can take the LCM? Simple. Simple, you can take the LCM. 8 plus 8r plus 8r square equal to 28r. Right? And now going for cross multiplication, I am put down here value. So 8r square plus 8r minus this one. So there, here is what? Minus 20r plus 8 equal to 0. So 8r square minus 20r plus 8 equal to 0. Or you can say take some common like 4. Taken as a 4 as a common. So 2r square minus 5r plus 4 to the 8 equal to 0. So 2r square minus 5r plus 2 equal to 0. And now you can construct factorize by with the help of splitting the middle term. So 2 ones are 2. So factor is what? 2n 1 by 2. So r is equal to what? R is 2 or 1 by 2. 2 value you can calculate. R equal to 2 or r equal to 1 by 2. So these two value you can calculate. The other two series will be 4. First number is a, second number is r. Your first number is what? A upon r, second is a, and your third number is what? Ar. So in this manner, you can calculate the value of a and r, and easily calculate first term, second term, and third term. Yes. So these are what? These are the selection of number might be in AP or in GP. In this manner, you can select a number and solve problem in very short time. So this one is what? This one is your selection of AP and GP, right? And now we are discussing some more property on your AM and GM. Last classes, we have to discuss the properties. Properties in the sense refer to AM and GM. Property related to arithmetic mean of two number with related to geometric mean of two number. Suppose two numbers are here, A and B. Arithmetic mean is A, geometric mean is G. So here A is what? Here A is equal to A plus B upon 2, comma, and G is what? Root of AB, right? And in this one case, you study that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. So I'm discussing the problem on this one sign, greater than or equal, or simple you can write on also greater than. And also you can consider the quadratic equation with the help of AM and GM with property number 2. Clear? But I am discussing on this one property. Property number 1. They ask, find the minimum value of the function fx is equal to 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power 1 minus x. What they ask? They ask, find the minimum value of this function. They ask, find the minimum. They ask, find the minimum value of this function. If they ask, find the minimum function, we can use this one formula. Arithmetic mean is greater than geometric mean. So, AM of these two numbers, put down these two numbers, 5 plus x, 5 over 1 minus x divided by 2. That's first number is A, second number is B. So AM is what? 5 raised to power x plus 5 raised to power 1 minus x whole divided by 2 is greater than their geometric mean. Geometric mean 5 to power x and 5 raised to power minus x. Root of this one. Okay. Here is 5 raised to power x cancel out, then greater than what? Root 5. So we can another way to represent 5 raised to power 1 minus x divided by 2 is equal to root 5. Shifting towards this one, we can get 5 to power x, 5 raised to power 1 minus x greater than 2 root 5. So that is what? That is the minimum value. That is the minimum value of the function. So minimum value function is what? 2 raised to power 2 into root 5. In this one manner, you can calculate the value of minimum value of this function. Using simple this scenario formula. This one is what? This one property number one you can use and get the exact result, right? If you are calculating the minimum value of the function, if you use this formula, arithmetic mean greater than geometric mean. If this number is greater than this one, so this is what? This is the minimum number of this one, because this one expression is what? That you can write fx. If fx greater than 2 root 5, that means fx is greater than 2 root 5. So minimum value of fx is what? So minimum value of fx is 2 root 5. Here. Now some more question I'm going to decide this property, property number 1. They ask, if the four distinct number, let A, B, C, D. A, B, C, and D. If they ask four number A, B, C, D, are in GP. They are the distinct position in GP, right? A, B, C, D are in GP. Then they asked, show that A plus D greater than 5 plus B plus C. They asked A plus D greater than B plus C. So if four number A, B, C are, we can take 3 and 3 because we studied the 3 number in GP, 3 number in GP. Suppose, first of all, case number one, if these three numbers are in GP, we are going for solution, right? If these three numbers are in GP, right now here, A, B, C are in GP. If these three numbers are in GP, you can say AM of this number is greater than GM. Again, using this property, yeah, A greater than G. Okay, if A greater than G. So AM is greater than GM. AM is what? The three number, that is A plus C upon 2 greater than root of AC. Root of AC is what? B. AM is greater than GM. And GM is what? Root of AC. And this one is what? This one is your B number. A plus C upon 2, that is what? That is your B. B value of B is what? If these three numbers are in GP. And the first we have to calculate the AP of these two numbers, AM of two number, A plus C upon 2 greater than B, or you can say also B. So A plus C greater than 2B. A plus C greater than 2B if these three numbers are in GP, A, B, C are in GP, right? If suppose next three number, suppose we take three next three number, that is if B, C, D are in GP, right here, if B, C, D are in GP, then what happened? If BCD are in GP, that means B plus, we are putting the value of AP, B plus D upon 2, B plus D whole divided by 2 is greater than C. So B plus D greater than 2C. This is your expression number 1, this is your expression number 2. On adding of these two numbers, this equation, write down here, B plus D greater than 2C. If you are going to add addition of this number, you can add this one, A plus C plus B plus D greater than 2B plus 2C, right? This one, whenever we can add this number. Here B shifting toward this one to B and C shifting toward this one is C. So this will result A plus D, right? If shifting towards C into this one side, 2C minus C, C. B towards this one, 2B minus B is greater than. So here is what? Here is A plus D. Here is A plus D. This one desired result. A plus D is greater than as what? B plus C. Right? we can write in this one manner. You can calculate the value of a plus d greater than this one. These are the question based on properties, that is AM and GM, arithmetic mean and geometric mean. Hope so this part is clear. You can ask any problem in this one question. Immediate ask, right? You can ask. Aap puch sakte, yes. We are putting the value of arithmetic means greater than equal to geometric. Our last 5 or 10 minutes, I will discuss, right? Suppose that if they ask e raised to power x plus, they ask or prove that e raised to power x minus e raised to power minus x, e raised to power x plus e raised to power minus x greater than 2. For these two real number, e to power x plus e raised to minus greater than 2. Again, using this property, what property? AM greater than GM. Arithmetic mean between two number is always greater than between two number. AM is greater than GM. So number of AM is what? E to power x plus e raised to power of minus x divided by 2. Greater than GM. Geometric mean of these two number. E to power x or e to power minus x. Geometric mean of these two number. This one cancel out. Your result will be what? E to power x plus e to power minus x greater than 2. One cancel root one is 1 into 2, answer is 2. So in this manner you can solve this such type of inequality problem using property AM and GM, right? These are the property based on AM and GM. Now there will be some word problem also in AP and GP, right? In 10th standard you are going to practicing day by day. Some more question on the, you can say that in the GP. If you already, we have to done it. And around Wednesday, Thursday, we will discuss again the property of, or you can say the word power of AP. So today I'm going to discuss the word problem based on GP, or you can say application based problem on GP, right? Now our question is what? Question says that, the number of bacteria in a certain culture double every hour. What is first line? First line is number of bacteria in a certain culture doubles every hour. If here is A, after 1 hour, this is 2A. After 1 hour. If suppose A let karte hain, then 1 hour what double, or that is 2A. If there were 30 bacteria present in a culture. If there are the 30 bacteria, this is the last condition, right? How many bacteria will present at the end of second hour, fourth hour? At the end of second hour, fourth hour, or nth hour? What? End of. The line is what? That is end of second hour, fourth hour, and nth. Okay. The first line is most important for you. That is what? That is the number of bacteria in a certain culture doubles every hour. If there were 30 bacteria present in the same culture originally, that means the first term is what? That is 30. Starting there was, this is your 30, right? And now, after that, 30, the second number is what? Your second number is, first is 30, then second double, that is 60, then double, 120, and so on. So here is A what? A is 30, R is 2. Here A is 30 and R is 2, right? Now, they ask what? Double at the end of. So number of bacteria at the end of nth hour is what? Nth term, you can say? at the end of nth term, you can assume that this one is what? This one is your nth value. So n is equal to 2. First, I'm going to participate in second one. This one I am doing, right? 2. A2 is what? So second term is what? So second term, yani A2, that is your AR. If A2 is AR, A is what? A is 30, R is 2. Your answer is 60. The second term is 60. Similarly, n equal to 4. You can calculate this one value. So second R, at the end of second R is what? Difference of 2, that is your 60. Okay. So that's why we can calculate by one value. Second R, fourth R, sixth R, or nth R.